Hello, I'm Robert Brock and I work at KDAB. Welcome to our new mini-series about designing your first embedded Linux device. In this four-part series, we're going to cover a range of topics that we think you should consider when getting started with your embedded Linux product. Of course, we can't provide the perfect answer for every viewer of this series, but we hope that by pointing out some key considerations, you'll be well on your way to a successful product. If reading is more your thing, or you want to know more than this mini-series covers, then there are links to our whitepaper on the same topic in the description. In this video, we are going to cover two topics that act as bookends for the whole product development process: making good hardware choices and shipping the product. In episode 2, we will look at selecting hardware in a bit more detail. Episode 3 will cover the application software stack. And we'll finish the series in episode 4 with a look at the development environment. Bad hardware decisions are one of the hardest things to work around as a software developer. One of the most common problems we get asked to fix is poor graphics performance. And in many cases, the problem boils down to cheap, low-performance graphics hardware, combined with ambitious, smartphone-like UI expectations. Often in these situations, the only thing we can do is turn off the fancy animations and simplify the UI to hide the hardware deficiencies. In the end, choosing graphics hardware based on cost means that you might end up spending more money on developer time, or you might have to cut back on features in your final product. Graphics aren't the only area we see affected by poor hardware choices. You should also consider how you expect your product to grow in the future. It's easy to add new software features later down the line, but is your processor going to be able to handle these extra features? Are you going to have storage space for larger binaries or new assets? We'll go into these topics in a bit more detail in episode 2, but the key point we want to make here is not to separate the hardware purchasing from the software planning. You should aim to have a holistic view of the product so that the hardware choices you make at the beginning can support your successful product as it grows in the future. At the other end of the product development process is shipping the product and then maintaining it once your product is out there in the wild. Deploying your production image to production hardware is not that hard, but deploying updates to your product once it's out there, being used by customers, is fundamentally more challenging. How are you going to get the update to the customer in the first place? How are you going to mitigate against failed updates? How are you going to secure the updates? And what about customer data or configurations on the device that you need to preserve between updates? Having answers to these questions early on means that your developers can use these processes as part of their development cycle. It means that your CI can use them to deploy and run tests on your hardware. You can use these processes to automate away some of the grind that comes with embedded product development. Other advantages include providing software developers with some context about where customer data needs to end up to be preserved. And finally, it means that your update process is tested and you've ironed out any kinks well before you come to ship or update the product for real. The last question I want to ask in this episode is, how are you going to deal with bugs and crashes once the product has been shipped? Obviously, in an ideal world, there wouldn't be any. But the reality is that customers are always going to find a way to break your product. Successful products will have a way to get meaningful crash reports and logs back to the developers. By considering and implementing this process early on, you can reduce the developer time spent trying to reproduce bugs found during testing. And remember, testing is not always going to be performed by developers with debuggers attached. You will likely have test products in the hands of key stakeholders. And just like your customers, when they find an issue, you can't rely on them to provide all the contextual information a developer needs to fix the issue. Having a way to get a crash dump, stack traces, and logs off your device vastly improves the chances of getting issues fixed in a timely manner. Finally, you might also consider a public bug reporting mechanism so that you can engage with your stakeholders or your customers and keep them updated on your solutions to the problems they have found. Designing your first embedded Linux device is not going to be easy. But hopefully this episode has got you thinking about some of the topics which we think really lay the groundwork for a successful product. In the next episode, we're going to look in a bit more detail at choosing your hardware. So thanks for watching, and don't forget there is a link to the print version of this mini-series in the description, and links to our website where you can reach out if you have any questions or need help at any point in your embedded Linux journey. I'll see you next time.